Until it was over. Thanks, Thomas. It's a blessing to be here tonight, and it's good to see so many of us gathered here and in this wonderful environment, in the environment of church. And I just want to read one scripture before we pray. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. Let's all gather our hearts together in prayer. Let's pray. Most gracious God and our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you tonight for the wonders that we see before us in the night sky, indeed, in the wonders of your creation around us. Lord, we are truly blessed, but not just these blessings you give us. You give us the blessings of knowing Jesus as our Savior and our Lord. And Lord, that is who we come to praise tonight. We come to praise our Savior, our Redeemer, the one who died for us and gave his life so that we might be set free, free to worship you in spirit and in truth. And that is how we approach you tonight, Lord, in the spirit, full of your truth in the gospel. And Lord, we come with our praises. We thank you for this church. We thank you for all that has been done in your name. And we thank you that we can gather our hearts together tonight and lift our voices in praise and worship. And we thank you for the bands that will lead us in that time. And indeed, we do pray that all the glory and the honor would go to you. Lord, we do pray for the ministry in Carloway and, Lord, for the two churches that work so well together in the unity of the Spirit. Indeed, Lord, we give praise to you for all that you have done and all that you continue to do. Through the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Thank you so much, Stevie. So we're going to sing four songs together, and we'll just introduce each one one by one. So we're going to start by singing the hymn, Behold God. Now, some of the songs that we sing tonight will be familiar to you. Some will be ones that are maybe new to you. But they're all very, very simple. They're all very beautiful. And they'll be very easy for you. So we're going to stand and we're going to sing loud and we're going to play a wonderful singing with the words.
Yeah. Life and death. The words are beautiful, they just focus us
Excellent. Very good. Very, very good indeed. Okay, so we're going to sing one more together just now with the help of our own musicians. And we're going to sing from Psalm 40. And that's one thing we always want to emphasize. We are so thankful to be able to sing beautiful hymns like we have sung already, but we also are so deeply appreciative of the place that the Psalms have in our worship. And we're going to sing the words of Psalm 40, verses 1 to 5, words that I'm sure are very familiar to many of you, and speak so powerfully of our experience. Sometimes we do feel like we're waiting for the Lord, and yet in time he answers our cries to him. He takes us from our distress. He sets our feet upon a rock. We're going to sing the first five verses, so that's three double verses, if you like, and then we're going to sing the first two verses again. So in terms of the way the singing sounds, it'll sound like four verses that we're doing. And we're singing it to a beautiful tune called Spansel Hill, which I'm sure many of you will know, but if you don't know it, it's extremely easy to pick up. If you give the musicians 30 seconds, there's an extremely dodgy accordion player who's about to join them.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to give you all a wee chance to stay seated now, but we're not going to stop singing because we're going to sing a Gaelic psalm together, and we're going to sing the last two verses of Psalm 23, verses 5 and 6. But I'm going to give you all a Gaelic psalm singing lesson because I'm sure there's one or two people here who've maybe not done it before or not done it for a long time. And there's no excuses tonight because we're all here together. We're all going to give it our best shot. And it doesn't matter if you can't pronounce every word. If you're not sure how to pronounce a word, just go because most words in Gaelic involve that at some point or another. But let me explain how it's going to work. In Gaelic psalm singing, we have a beautiful tradition stretching back many, many generations of putting out the line. And so in a moment, Dáil is going to come up and he will sing the first two lines of the verse that's on your screen. Don yesich bord erbeil monav le olig rein mochiaun. And we'll all sing that together. So as he starts, we all join in, we sing through those first two lines together. And then from the third line onwards, the lining out begins. So Dáil will sing the third line on his own, Cuid harish ha mochup an fos, and then we will sing it back. And so what tends to happen is that the presenter puts the line out quite quickly, and then we sing it back very, very slowly. So we will stretch out the notes. So if you rush along when you're singing, you'll probably get lost because the words tend to get stretched out. And then the pattern continues. Dáil will sing out, Ek meid the la na haun, and then we'll sing it back, and then we'll go into the next verse, which are very familiar verses, words of Psalm 23. Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And the same pattern will continue. Dáil will sing out one line, and we will sing the line out back to him. So see, now you're all experts in Gaelic psalms. So you know exactly what you're doing. And so it's such a beautiful and rich part of our worship heritage in our community. And it's so important to us that we keep this going for generations to come. And that's why it's rare now to have as many people as this singing a Gaelic psalm together. So this is a wonderful opportunity for us to do this. So I'll invite Dáil to come forward. We'll put it back to the previous verse and we'll sing the last two stanzas of Psalm 23. Go yesich bord er beil monav.
Go yesich bord er beil monav le Yeah, yeah, it's cold. Moris Molo.
That was incredible. Well done. That was so good. It's now a huge pleasure to invite Duncan to come up. He's going to sing for us. Duncan has been serving as Minister of the Church of Scotland here in Carloway for many years now and has become such a deeply loved and appreciated part of our community. And we value our gospel partnership together so much, and it's always a huge privilege to be able to share in serving together. So Duncan's going to sing for us. I'll let Duncan explain what he's going to sing, and we welcome you warmly. Thank you.
Could you give me a microphone?
I'll give you a microphone.
Double mic. Thank you, dodgy accordion player. You were brilliant, actually. Well, we're going to continue with this Psalm theme, and this is an adaptation of Psalm 103. And it's quite, as Thomas says, it's an easy tune to pick up. Every tune seems to be quite easy. So I'll begin the intro, and hope you'll catch it up. And in every verse, we repeat the last line. Okay, so I'll begin, and then when you feel you've got the tune, would you please stand up and we'll sing it together. Is that coming through on the microphone?
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that in me is His holy. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and not forgetful be of all His gracious benefits He has bestowed on me. Of all His gracious benefits He has bestowed on me.
I'm going to stop there, raise this mic a wee bit up here, and ask you all to stand now. And we'll go on to verse 2.
Our iniquities all He most graciously forgave. Diseases and pain He does heal and He relieve. Who doth with abundance of good things, He does satisfy my mind, so that even as the evil renewed is thy youth, God righteous judgment He executes for all oppressed. His ways to Moses He has asked. Act, may known to
Well, I think we'll steal that song, if that's okay, Duncan. That's a wonderful, wonderful arrangement of Psalm 103. So good. I'm now going to invite the musicians from the High Free. They're going to come forward and get themselves set up. It'll take them a couple of minutes, I'm sure, just to get everything plugged in and organized. But we're going to sing four more songs together with them in a few minutes. So we'll just give them a couple of minutes to get everything plugged in and organized. One of the great things about an evening like this is that it brings us all together from different communities, different backgrounds, and even from different congregations and denominations. And that's something that we appreciate and value and rejoice in so much. It's amazing for me to be able to look out over you this evening and see people who've come from different church families all across the island. And it's a huge and wonderful reminder that we're actually all one family. And we rejoice that we're able to do that. We should be blooming well doing it a lot more. And it's so good to be able to worship together. Let me tell you about some of the songs that they're going to sing. I hope I get this in the right order. They're going to start with a song called Here We Stand, which will be familiar, I think, to some of you. And then after that, it's Yet Not I, But Christ in Me, which is a song that we often sing here in Carloway, one that we love very, very much indeed. Then, His Mercy Is More, is that right? Yes, His Mercy Is More. And then they're going to conclude with Creation Sings, which is a really, really joyful, wonderful song for us to sing together. So, do I need to carry on waffling, or are you ready to go? So, this all looks very good. So, let me say a couple of songs, and I'll do my grand introduction of all of them to give you a break from standing. But we're going to start singing together Here We Stand. And there's a great, just a great statement for us to make as we stand together as brothers and sisters in Jesus, united through our one risen and risen Savior. So I'll invite you all to stand and just
we
amazing. I'll let you take a seat. The next song we're going to sing is a beautiful hymn that speaks so powerfully of the fact that, you know, on our own, we are not good enough. On our own, we're not strong enough. We don't know enough. We're not capable enough. But the whole gospel rests on the fact that it's not about us. It's all about Jesus. And that's captured so powerfully in the words of this hymn, "Yet not I, but Christ in me." And it speaks beautifully of just the sufficiency of Jesus, of everything that he's done for us. I'll ask you to stay seated for this song. We'll let you just give your legs a wee rest, and we'll sing these beautiful words as the musicians lead us.
My strength.
Beautiful, thank you. We've got a couple more songs to sing together, but before we do, I'm delighted to introduce all of these wonderful musicians to you. At the back, you have John in the Dunns, who you may have seen before, who's been seconded to the event for the evening. And we've got Annabelle on violin, we've got Ali on guitar, we've got Elena on piano, we've got Spangy, whose real name I have never known for the last 30 years, I don't think anybody actually does. And here we have Lexi and Lexi's mum, real name Leslie. So it's so, so good of you all to come over. We just appreciate it so much, and it's so kind of you to come this evening, and it's just a massive blessing for us to have you lead our worship together. We're going to sing now the beautiful words of the hymn, His Mercy Is More. I think that this is an incredibly important hymn for anyone who comes here tonight feeling like they are a failure, feeling like they are not good enough, feeling like they've made too many mistakes. This hymn reminds us that God's mercy is greater than our biggest mistakes, and we can come to him in all our need. His mercy is everything that we need. So let's stand and sing these wonderful words together. It's just a really lively, wonderful song, just speaking about how all of us and the whole universe is made to give praise and honour and glory to our amazing God. So we're going to stand and sing together.
Mm-hmm. And the foolish said to the wise, give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out. But the wise answered, saying, since there is not enough for us and for you, go rather to the dealers and buy for yourselves. And while they were going to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the marriage feast, and the door was shut. Afterwards, the other virgins came also, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered, truly I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know not neither the day nor the hour. Now, these are verses which are familiar to all of you. And one of the things I remembered when Thomas phoned me to ask me if I would speak here, I remember many, many years ago, 25, he reminded me, 25 years ago, I asked Thomas to be a junior leader at a Free Church camp. You know, one thing about Thomas that's really quite amazing, when he was that age, he looked older. And now that he's older, he looks younger than he is. Have you ever noticed that about him? So he came with me to a Free Church camp, and we had a wonderful time, and we came back on the Saturday evening, and it was the first time Thomas ever spoke as a Christian in public in the YM. That was 25 years ago, and he's done pretty well since then. And we had a fantastic time at camp. And one of the things I remember in particular is we went caving. If you've never gone caving, please don't do it. And it's quite remarkable. There was no risk assessment. We had no permission from the parents. We just did it. This man said he would take us caving, and we went and followed him. He was the leader of the center we were in. And I was at the very end in case we lost anyone. And there were times it was quite frightening. And he took us deep somewhere. Don't ask me where. But it was very deep and underneath the ground. And he told us to switch our lights off. And we had torches, head torches, and he told us to switch them off. And we switched them off, and we couldn't see each other. And he said to us, this is as dark as it will ever be for you. You will never experience darkness like this again. And it was quite frightening. And I still remember it 25 years later. I don't know whether Thomas does or not, but he is nodding. And we spoke about it when we came back on the Sunday night. And I don't want to dwell on it because I want to talk about Jesus tonight. But this passage speaks about darkness, because there is darkness coming when the Son of Man comes for the second time, when Jesus comes. Because there were wise and foolish virgins, but in heaven there will only be wise ones. And the foolish ones will be in darkness. I don't know where that darkness is. I don't know where hell is. But it's at the end of a life without Christ. And if you're here tonight and you've never committed your life to Jesus, I just want you to listen for 8 minutes now to hear the story of what Jesus has done for you. And I think there's a reason for you being here tonight if you're not a Christian. And that is, you've heard such wonderful music, you've heard great words, powerful words, and they're speaking to you. And you have an opportunity to ask Christ into your life. And we'll never be like this again. It's a fantastic meeting, but we'll never gather like this again. There'll always be somebody missing, or someone will be somewhere else. But tonight, you've got the opportunity to meet Christ. And I want to just talk about commonality among those virgins. There were foolish ones and there were wise ones. But both lots, they listened. And I want to tell you something. It's not enough just to listen and hear the gospel. Because many people listen and hear the gospel, but they never accept. Some of you will remember in the days gone by when you were invited to a wedding, people went round the houses to invite you. They didn't send you invitation cards. They knocked on your door, and they came in, and you had a yarn with them, and they would invite you to the wedding of their son or their daughter. It was really quite something. And I remember in Scalpe seeing them coming. And they used to say in Gaelic, they're coming with the invitation. And you used to get a wee bit excited to see if they would come to your house. And you wondered as they passed by whether they would come up. They never knocked, of course. They just walked in. And you know that tonight Christ is inviting you. He's coming specially to you tonight. He's knocking on your door. It's not an invitation, it's just setting out to everyone, but it's coming to you personally. And it's giving you the same invitation as he gave those wise virgins. And I really beg with you to listen to his invitation. But it's more than listening. And that's what I want to emphasize later. And there was also a longing in those virgins' heart. They longed to meet the bridegroom. And you might have a longing tonight to meet Christ. Maybe that's why you're here. But that's not enough either. They longed because you remember when the bridegroom, the very fact that they were there meant that they longed to meet the bridegroom. But they also, when they ran out of oil, they asked for oil of the other virgins. They longed to go there and they wanted oil. But there was no oil for them. They were too late to ask for the oil. But they did long to meet the bridegroom because they asked for the oil. And they also went and knocked on the door. When the door was shut, they knocked on it because there was a longing in their hearts to meet with the bridegroom. And maybe you've got a longing tonight to meet Jesus, but that's not enough either. Because the longing might not go beyond the longing, and it didn't go for these foolish virgins. But why I want you to know tonight is that the only way to accept Christ is to confess your sins before him and accept him as Lord and Savior of your life. But what does that really mean, to accept him as Lord and Savior of your life? Maybe you've seen a film called Double Jeopardy, have you? I don't know whether you have or not. It's an old film. It's a really interesting film. And it's double jeopardy in law means that you cannot be charged with the same crime twice. And this man set up his own murder by his wife. And his wife was imprisoned for murdering her husband. But the husband was still alive. It's a strange way to get rid of your wife. But that's how he did it. But when she got out of prison, she was determined to murder him because she couldn't be charged again with the same crime. I won't tell you the whole story, but she went searching for him with a gun. And that is double jeopardy. Under double jeopardy, you cannot be charged with the same crime twice. Now, when Christ went to Calvary for you and for me, he saved us from hell there. He went through hell for me and for you. He was condemned on my behalf and on your behalf. He was a substitute for me there and for you. See, my sins are horrific, and I'm sure Thomas would say the same. I have all the sins that anyone can think of. I have got envy, I am jealous, I covet, I do, you know, I mean, when I see beautiful boats coming into the harbor, my goodness, the covetousness in my heart, it's just amazing, because I'd love to have boats like that. But I have all those things that everyone else suffers from, every single one. But Jesus died for me, and that is what my hope is. On the day of judgment, what will happen to me is I will stand before God, and that's a quite frightening thought, to stand before God, even for a Christian. But I'll stand before God, and I think, this is the way I think it'll be, I will be accused of many, many sins. And I will have to stand there and accept that I committed those sins. But I will have a lawyer, an advocate. And that lawyer's name is Jesus Christ. And he will be sitting by my side. You know, when you've got a good lawyer, it's amazing what you can do. But I will have the best lawyer that has ever lived. And he will listen to the devil accusing me of my sins, all of which will be true. And then the judge, who will be the Father, will stand up, and I will have to say that I am guilty. And my lawyer will have to stand up and say, yes, he's guilty, but I've paid the price for his sins. And that is what Christ has done. And because of Christ has paid the price of my sins, I cannot be condemned again. See, if you look in the gospel, it says, if you confess your sins, God is just and will forgive. Because he is just, he has to forgive us our sins. It is impossible for God to condemn us if we believe in Jesus. And the reason for that is because he is just. He's honorable. If someone else has taken my price to pay for my sins, God cannot. He is unable to condemn me for those sins. And Jesus will stand up and he will say, I have paid for Roddy's sins. And because I have paid for them, you cannot and you won't condemn him. And the Father will agree with that. Do you know that, I don't know whether it's still like, whether it still is there or not, but there used to be a place in Dublin called the Place of No Hope. It used to be a hostel. And usually with people with addiction problems went there. Do you know that such a place tonight doesn't exist? There is no place in this world of no hope because Christ has died for us. And you may have come here tonight and you may think there is no hope for me, but there is hope for you because Christ has died. It's a matter of accepting what Christ has done. In 1829, I'm running out of time, 1829, George Wilson was convicted of murder in America. His friends decided that they would put an appeal to the president for him to be pardoned. They appealed to the president, and President Andrew Jackson pardoned him. And the sheriff refused to carry out the sentence because he had been pardoned. George Wilson refused to accept the pardon, refused point blankly to accept it. Sheriff didn't know what to do. The president didn't know what to do. So the president sent it to the Supreme Court. And Chief Justice Marshall responded by saying that the pardon was simply a piece of paper. Unless it was accepted by the person it was implicated, the person implicated, it was worthless. God is offering you a pardon tonight through Jesus Christ. If you don't accept it, it is worthless. And you will be like those foolish virgins. You have the opportunity to accept it because he loves you. God loves you and God loves me more than I can ever understand. I am more sinful than I'll ever believe or understand, because we all think we're not too bad. But we are more sinful than we can ever believe. But God is more merciful. We read it and sang it in the hymn there. Our sins, they are many, but his mercies are more. I plead with you tonight to accept Christ. It might be your last opportunity. We've had 10 minutes to talk about it. You've got the rest of your life to think about it, but the Bible tells us to make up our minds today, tonight. So I would plead with you to accept Christ as your Savior. And if you do, what a wonderful evening it'll be for everyone in Carloway. It'll be a fantastic evening. And for you, it will be the most wonderful night of your life. It'll change you forever. Thank you for listening so well. God bless you.
Thank you so much, Roddy. It brings back so many amazing memories for me because, you know, when I became a Christian, way back in the 90s, which to some of you is ancient history, for some of you probably feels like yesterday, two amazing things happened. When you come to faith in Jesus, just like Roddy said, it brings a joy and a peace and a hope in your life that nothing else can. But the other amazing thing that it does is that it brings you into a new family. A family of brothers and sisters all across the island, all across the world. And that's been something so amazing for me to share. Roddy and I go back so long, and it's amazing to have shared so much together over so long. And that's the amazing thing about the gospel. It brings us into new life with Jesus. And it brings us into an amazing new life together. And so it's so special for me to have you here tonight, Roddy, and to have all of you here. And it's just, yeah, I don't want to take away anything from what Roddy said. All I can say is just that everything he says is so true. And everything that Jesus gives us is absolutely amazing. We've got two items before we close. The first is a Gaelic song that Isabel is going to sing, and she's going to be accompanied by Mary on the clarsach and one or two other musicians just giving a wee bit in the background. I'm going to invite them both to come up, and it's a beautiful song. I'll let Isabel explain a wee bit more about what the song is about. You'll be able to just stay seated while they sing, and then after that, we're going to conclude with the wonderful words of Amazing Grace. So if you give us a moment just to get everything set up, we'll be ready to go.
This song is sung by a band called Sheehan. It was an English spiritual song that's been translated into Gaelic, and it talks about when we pass away and we're buried in the cemetery, not to be feeling sad and down for us because we're going to be in heaven. And it talks about on the day that Christ returns, just rising again to be with him. So it's talking about from the side of people who are left behind who are mourning, and from the side of the person who's gone on to glory. And I just always think of Dalmor when I sing it, because I don't think there's a better place to rise again.
Call him more reward for Nachsrud Jodfan. siwl don nhw a'i gnesod hawl far yn dyad o'r chi ar nefw a'i nach gawn. Smi bio awn yn doch y sedd yn wapnia gyn wai jog ddeniedd y ffris yn sychdia is dwysgyn y maddaf ry ffawn Gabriel srit o gwys y ies yn hawn chlyg hawn. Clwyd o ia, clwyd o ia,
that's a song that you just want to never end. That was amazing, amazing. Well, we've reached our final song of the evening, which is one that you all know very, very well. And in so many ways, I think that this song sums up everything that we've sung about tonight, everything that Roddy spoke about tonight. The fact that everything in the gospel rests on the amazing grace of God in Jesus. The fact that he gives us freely what we do not deserve. He promises us what we could never earn. And he gives us more than we could ever imagine. And so we can sing these wonderful words of amazing grace as we close together. And we have a special treat for you. We're going to be accompanied by some small pipes as we stand and sing together. So let's stand and we'll sing Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
We thank you for such a special evening, for the amazing blessing of being together, united as a family together in your name. We thank you for the amazing gift of music, of song, of instruments, and of all the opportunity that we have to give you our praise and our thanks through singing together. We thank you that we're able to share this time together tonight. And we pray, Father, that for all of us here, you would meet with us and speak to us all so that we would hear your voice calling us closer to you, and that for any here tonight who are seeking you, that tonight would be the night that they would be able to say, I once was lost, but now I'm found. Thank you for everyone who's come. Thank you for everything that we've been able to enjoy. And may your blessing be on our time together just now. Thank you for the food that's been provided. Thank you for every blessing that you've given to us through your Son, our amazing Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray in his name. Amen. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you to give a big round of applause to all our musicians and singers, because they've been fantastic. So let me just explain a little bit about the teas and coffees. We've got two serving stations. So we've got a hatch at the back there, and we've got a table here. So please just, if you're towards the back, go to the hatch. If you're towards the front, come to the table here. There's lots of you here, which is fantastic, but can I ask that when you go to the hatch or to the table, go take your tea and coffee, your cake, and then come back to your seats or to another seat, just so that we don't have too much crowding around the hatches and the serving table over here. We'll just keep the movement nice and slick, and I'm sure you'll be able to all get a nice cake and a scone together. On behalf of everyone in Carloway, thank you so, so much for coming, and we look forward to seeing you soon.